experience at Dudley was like, I don't want to say a movie, but it was pretty close to what I could fathom as far as a high school experience, as far as sports, friends, extracurriculars, academics, clubs, all the like fun stuff and like nitty gritty. It was perfect for me. People that I was surrounded with, I enjoyed them and they enjoyed me. They looked out for me, peers and teachers. So I enjoyed every minute of it. The Academy at Dudley is a program and you're in it from freshman year to senior year. And you finish high school in 3 years. And then your last year, you're at either GCCC or ANT. And this year, I was at GCCC Jamestown since I'm in the health science track. And I enjoyed being on campus there as well. Freshman year, I started out with the women's basketball team, and I've been a manager all 4 years in high school. I also was on the women's varsity golf team, and it was actually the first one in history at Dudley, and we had a nice little article write-up and everything, so that was interesting. I was inducted in the National Honor Society my junior year, and then my senior year, I was president. I was also inducted into the National Technical Honor Society my junior year. Also my junior year, I started the Gender and Sexuality Alliance, or GSA, at my school. It is still up and running, and I've given like all the tools that the other members will need to keep it going after I leave. So I'm really excited to see where all that heads. Outside of school, even though it's sort of like an extracurricular, I'm a Girl Scout. I just recently earned my Girl Scout Gold Award. For my Gold Award project, I conducted a sock and underwear drive for 8 local schools here in Gilbert County Schools, elementary, middle, and high schools. And I partnered with the principals and social workers at all the schools to make sure that I was hitting the targeted needs at each school. And I donated over 500 pairs of socks and over 230 pairs of underwear in total during my entire project. Eventually, Carolina was the one that I ended up picking because Morehead Cane. I got offered the Morehead Cane, and it's an opportunity that I just couldn't pass up. I had been accepted to 11 schools, and my top two were down to Carolina and North Carolina A&T. And it was down to the wire for a good little minute until I got offered the Morehead Cane. And then my mom and dad were like, you can't pass this up. Like, this is a great opportunity. You'd be crazy if you didn't take it. So that was, like, the final straw that really came back. And I was like, okay, I'm going to Carolina. And so far I've been connecting with people that are also planning to go there in the fall, and they're just amazing. For everyone at Dudley that has helped support me over the past 4 years, I just want to say thank you for making my high school experience one of the best times during my life and one of the best high school experiences that I could have imagined.
Hi, class of 2020, Dr. John Carlos Miller here, the principal of Weaver Academy. Congratulations to you.
Dr. Sharon Contreras, the superintendent of the Guilford County School, and I'd like to congratulate the entire class of 2020.
I'm Delia from Jamestown Middle School, and you're watching GCS TV.
Thank you. everybody. I wanted to take a minute to show you the setup that we have for today. The game is called Plastic Punters. We are going to use those 10 plastic bags to help us with our kicking and our punting. Really kind of our dribbling, but we're going to do some more striking. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Bag is spread out over there, and what's going to happen is I'm going to have to dribble it down the hallway so that it gets into my goal. Then I gotta run back. Dribbling with our feet, so they should be light, short taps. When you're finished with round one, then you're going to go set them all back up and do it again. Let me show you. Round two. This one begins with my same pile of 10 bags, and I have the same distance to travel. Only difference this time, I'm not just dribbling the ball or the bag all the way down. I'm actually gonna pick it up and punt it. Then I gotta let it land and pick it up and punt it again. Let's see how well that works, getting it all the way down to my goal box. All right, are we ready? Now, when we punt, we have to hold the bag in front of us, let it go, and kick it. Now it's over here, so I'm going to pick it up again, hold it in front, and kick. That was kind of a lot, but round three and four, we're gonna have to make it just a little bit harder. Stay tuned. So here we are, ready for round three. Down here, outside, I've got my 10 bags, and I just put a spoon on them so they would hold their place. And my goal box is gonna be right down here, just beyond my red sweatshirt. Now the distance is the same amount of steps. So what is more challenging about doing the dribbling out here? I mean, it's the same distance, right? Well, yes, we are outside, that's one. But what do you think would make it harder for us? Why do you think I put those spoons on the bags? That's right, we have a lot of wind blowing. I wonder how that's going to affect my game. Three, two, one, go. I'm gonna pick up the spoon. This one is the dribbling. Oh, my goodness. Oh. Little taps, let it fall back to the ground. One. My next one, I'm gonna ball it up. Here we go. Skid down. There we go. Little tap, let it hit the ground. Whew. Go back down for another one. When you finish all 10, then you are ready for round four. Okay, boys and girls, I'm fairly certain that round four is gonna be our toughest yet. Remember that round one was inside and we dribbled or small little taps the bags on the floor inside. Then round two was the punching where we balled it up and kicked it up into the air. Round three brought a new challenge because we came outside and we started battling this wind. Round four is gonna be punching. Four, punching, here we go. Three, two, one. I'm gonna go all the way down. Get my first one. Ball it up, toss, kick. Oh, this is so much harder. Ball it up, toss, kick. Ball it up. And one. And then we've got to finish all the rest. I hope you enjoy this game, boys and girls. I miss you guys a lot. Have a great time. See you soon.
College works with, we have freshmen and sophomore year. That's basically all of your high school classes, everything that's required for high school. And then the next 2 years we spend at Guilford College with all the different college kids, basically pretending to be one of the college kids, and neither the professor nor the rest of the class know that you're an early college student. High school at the early college is definitely pretty stressful, but it teaches you how to manage your time and study wisely, and it really teaches you a lot of life skills as well. Being able to be in college classes and be expected to rise to that level at an earlier age definitely has prepared me for a lot of different situations. High Point University was always at the top of my list. I grew up here in High Point and I had family friends go there. I have family friends who teach there, and it's always been on my radar. So when I started looking around for colleges, I toured there first and just couldn't find another college that really matched it. So I was really grateful when I was able to receive that scholarship and allow me to go to that school.
Ready? Go get them. Congratulations.
To everyone at the Early College at Guilford, I miss you guys and I can't wait until we're able to meet up again. It's been a really great 4 years. I miss you guys.
My name is Cameron Penix. I go to Eastern Guilford High School, and I'm attending UNCG in the fall.
Hi, my name is John Romero, and I attend the Academy of Smith. I am a Governor School West alumni and president of HOSA at my school, and this fall I will be attending Guilford College, and I'll be majoring in pre-med.
Hi, my name is Hope Rackers. In January, I was thrilled to find out that I got into Georgia Tech. This is my acceptance letter. I'm excited to announce that I've officially accepted Georgia Tech and plan to attend in the fall. Go Jackets!
My name is Marcellus Davis. I'm a senior at James B. Dudley High School, and I'm announcing that I will be attending North Carolina A&T State University, majoring in accounting. Shouts out to NCAT 2024.
Hey, I'm David Black, and I'm a senior at Gimsley High School, and this fall I will be attending UNC Charlotte.
Hi, my name is Kayla Peterman, and I'm a senior at the Middle College at Bennett, and I'll be going to Winston-Salem State University in the fall.
War That Saved My Life by Kimberly Brubaker Bradley. Is called Maniac McGee. It's by one of my favorite authors, Jerry Spinelli. I love everything about this book. The main character, Maniac, becomes an orphan, and he finds himself going between the east side and the west side, his racially divided town at the time. But Maniac finds that he fits in on both sides of town, and he works to kind of bring the two sides of town together. It's a great book. I highly recommend it.
If so, make sure to catch Skinny Buns, about a fifth grader Alex Frankovich who has a big mouth that gets himself into all kinds of humorous predicaments. You'll be laughing out loud. Make sure to catch this book.
The Little Brute Family by Russell Hoban.
I recommend Blueberries for Sale. It's an award winner, Caldecott winner. It's got amazing illustrations, and it's got some onomatopoeia in it, so enjoy.
It's a great book. Check it out.
Get your thrill on with Thrill Rides, top 10 roller coasters in America.
And so I started school in Guilford County Schools and then came to Claxton in second and third grade. And then Bluford and Irwin and Kaiser and Grimsley. So I'm a 1987 Grimsley graduate. And I taught for about a year and decided after talking to my principal that I wanted to go back and get my master's in administration. She said, "You would make a really great administrator." And I said, "Wow. I probably want to reach more students than just those 25 in my class, so that would be wonderful." But I didn't get an assistant principal's job until 1996. I interviewed for several. I even interviewed here at Claxton for an assistant principal's job, but I did not get that one or the other one, so I just didn't get a job until 96. And Ken Wheat was the principal at Northeast Middle School. Never thought I'd work in a middle school. But he interviewed me and he was like, you are great. I was 25, 26 years old, around there, one of those ages. And the superintendent had told me that he thought I was too young. But at that time, most people were over 40 or 50 as administrators. So I was younger than most. But still, I knew what I wanted to do and I was determined. So I was blessed to have Ken Wheat in my life, and he hired me to be his assistant principal. And I worked at Northeast Middle for 3 years. And then one of the associate superintendents, Mary Martin, came to me and said, are you ready for a school? I was like, yes. And so I was named the principal at Oak Ridge Elementary School. I was 29 years old at that time. So a lot of people ask me now, you know, you're 50 years old, you're retiring. I've been a principal for 20 years. I mean, a very long time, and I've enjoyed every minute of it, but that's a very long time to be a principal. So I was at Oak Ridge for 2 years, Colfax for 1 year, Ferndale Middle for 3 years, and then I heard that Judy Jones was retiring from Claxton. I said, that is where I want to go. That's my school. I went there as a kid, wanted to work there as an assistant principal. That is my school, and I want to go there. So in 2005, I came to Claxton, and here I am. I mean, 15 years later, retiring. There were opportunities to go to other places, but I absolutely love this school. I love the parents, the kids. Several of the parents, especially when I first got here, were people that I went to school with. And so it's just a family, a community, and it's, I just absolutely love it. I just couldn't imagine leaving. But I knew that this was the right time to, well, I didn't know about COVID-19, but I knew that this year was the right time for me to leave, because I feel like I've done all that I could do here. And I was hopeful and prayerful that Mr. Toma would be able to follow me, and that's what's going to happen. So I'm able to leave and really know that my school will be taken care of. Certainly the kids. I mean, that's why I do what I do. So our students and their love for learning and wanting to be accepted, wanting to be loved, wanting to learn, all of that is why I come here every day. And so our staff is great as well, and certainly the parents, but the children are the reason that I continue to do what I do. The children, I mean, these last few months has been extremely hard, because every morning I greet the children, we dance in the hallway, you know, I'm walking in classes, seeing kids, and just, I mean, they just lift your spirits. And so not being able to have that, I guess, was preparation for retirement, but not the way that I wanted it to be. But I will miss definitely the most. I will also miss just talking with teachers about issues that they're having and helping them to think through some solutions. And knowing that sometimes there aren't solutions. Sometimes we cannot fix it. We cannot make it all right. But we can just do what we know how to do. We can reach out for other resources and try to get help. But it is helpful to talk through things as well. Well, I worked for several years as an adjunct professor in the Masters of School Administration program at A&T. And I really, really enjoyed that. So I hope to continue to work on the college level, helping those people that are teachers or other educators that want to be school administrators. my message to teachers is pretty much the same thing as my message to the kids, because I just hope to see all of them in the future and be able to hug them. I've seen them, you know, here and there, and some that have come in, but I, you know, I'm a hugger and a toucher, and I'd like to find out how people are doing, how their personal lives are going, their families, and so I'm missing that as well. So my message is that I hope that our relationship can continue, even though I'm not here and I'm not their administrator. Hopefully it'll be even better. And that's my niece and nephew, Miles and Amanda, and those were the pictures of kids. If anybody ever came in my office, they would see. But those are my pride and joy, even though they're not my kids. They are my kids because I don't have my personal children. My parents moved to Georgia for a while, but then they came back to Greensboro, so they live right around the corner from me, and I enjoy talking with them and seeing them and being close to them. I'm really supportive of my sorority, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, and we do a lot of work in the community, so that takes up a lot of time. I've held an office with my sorority for, I don't know, 10, 12 years, and so I do enjoy that. I also enjoy traveling and reading, and yesterday I was on a boat, so I just enjoy adventurous things like that. So that's just a little bit about me personally. Of course I'll miss the building. I tell you what, when I moved in this office probably about 10 years ago, I felt a little something because I was not the best student. And I tell teachers and students that all the time. I didn't always make the best decisions, which is why I can understand when students don't. So I had to come in this office with Mr. Morrow, who was my principal when I came to Claxton, a few times to get a little conversation. And that's what I try to do with kids when they come in here. Oh, certainly. I really wish and hope that I can see all of them again. I know that we all won't be in the school together. That's not going to happen for me. But I hope that I will be able to see each and every one of them again and hug them and just encourage them and tell them that I believe in them and I know that they can be successful. They have all the tools to do that.
Welcome to my nice sandy beach. How's everybody doing today? Hope you're doing great. I have a new activity to share with you. Well, some of you may have heard of this one before. It's called pool, and I don't mean the one that you were swimming. This particular game actually involves a cue stick that we're going to use from a broom handle today, and several pool balls, which we're going to use sock balls. These are all placed on a table, and using your cue stick, you hit the ball into pockets, which we're going to use some cups for that today. This is considered another striking sport because you're using one object to strike something else. What I'm going to do is show you how to do it, and you're going to have a special mission. Are you ready? Please. Let me show you by setting up the first one. So you're going to lay your cup over here on the side, okay? And then we're just going to do it kind of close just so that you guys can all see. This sock ball, I mean, it fits in there, right? But it's a tight squeeze, so I got to be pretty accurate. And that's okay too. You might have some bigger cups at home. You might have, like I have, a little bucket right here that's a little bit larger, so that could help, you know, when you're trying to shoot. But what you're trying to do
is the first one, you want to be about a hand distance away. So I'm going to take the blue cup, okay? I'm going to put my hand down, and then I'm going to put the sock ball right behind that. Now I'm ready. Now, you have to, I like to make a V with my thumb, and then I set the hole right inside that V. Some people like to make a circle. And in that circle, they put the stick so that it slides. Some people like to put it down this way. You have to figure out what works best for you. And let me show you directly on what. So my hand is like this. I take my hand and put my thumb up a little bit, okay? And then I just slide. Now, this white end is what's gonna hit the sock ball, and hopefully the sock ball goes into the goal. Cross your fingers, because this is a little bit tough to do. Gotta make sure you got enough space. All right, remember it's a striking sport, so I got everything ready, and ooh, didn't even have a little push. Good, all right. So once you get it in, dump it back out. Now, instead of just being one hand away, you're gonna try to put the ball two hands away. Okay, go for another shot. Make sure you got room behind you, because that'll affect your shot. Get your hands ready and, ooh, this little stinking ball. Now, you can't pick the cup up and you can't pick the sock up, so you gotta move around to hit it so it gets back straight in front of the cup. Oh, we're getting close. All right, and, all right. Now, for your third turn, you're gonna do three hands away. All right, so three hands away, and go. All right, keep doing the hands away. One, and then two, and three, and four, until you get five. Once you have practiced five hands away, then you're gonna take several cups, and you are gonna set up your own obstacle, well, basically your own pool hall. So put these in the different corners. To score some points. Oh boy, that angle is pretty tough. I got my hands ready. And, oof, I need another shot. Okay. Now, if you were playing with somebody else, you're gonna take a shot, and then your sibling will take a shot. And then you take a shot. Even if you have a little bump, that's considered a shot. So then it's the other person's turn. Keep going until everyone has scored in all of the different buckets. Or cups, or whatever it is that you have, and have some fun with it. Hope you guys enjoy. See you soon.
High school experience at Northeast has been a lesson to me, because when I first entered school, I was a shy, really not like outgoing person. And then like once I started joining clubs, and like I reconnected with some of my friends from middle school, from Northeast Middle School, because I went to Northeast Middle School also. So once I reconnected with them and everything, I just started blossoming to this person. The HBCU tour is founded by Mr. Blake E. Odom and his wife Olivia Odom. It's where they get a group of students. And they take like two or three buses, and we go to historically black colleges. We learned the history of the colleges, the founders, what our ancestors have fought so hard for our education. When I went, we went to like Martin Luther King's house, we went to the George Carver Museum in Tuskegee. We went to the Kingsley Plantation in Florida, and we just learned about all the hardships that our ancestors have overcame. So Norfolk State, as you can see in my shirt. Okay, so Norfolk State is a historic Black college in Norfolk. My mom, she went there. She graduated class of 2003. And I was somewhat born on campus, but wasn't. She didn't know at the moment that she was going into labor because she was at track practice. And so she was just, yeah. And so she was just like running. She felt pains or whatever. She was like, oh my gosh, the baby's coming. And so then they had to hurry up and put into like a little locker room or something like that until the ambulance came. And then that's when they took us to the hospital or whatever. So ever since then, I've been called the campus baby or whatever, like around my mom's friends. Like the teachers, while my mom was in class, they would like hold me and like teach. I just want to thank all the educators, my mentors, everyone who's guided me into becoming the young lady that I am now. Thanks to GYC, thanks to the SHIELD mentorship.
Nyla Denise Waller.
Thanks to Northeast, I know I had a rocky start, and I know, especially Ms. Johnson, I know sometimes I wasn't the best, my attitudes and stuff, but thank you for dealing with it, all my teachers. I really appreciate you. And all my friends, I love y'all. Thank y'all so much. I wouldn't be here without y'all and my parents and my family. Thank you, Mommy. I love you so much.
My name is Emil Flowers. I attend Grimsley High School. I'll be attending High Point University next fall. I plan on majoring in computer science and engineering, and I'll also be continuing in my basketball career.
My name is Laura McDaniel. I go to Southern Guilford High School, and I'll be a UNCG Spartan in the fall.
Dear Alexia Ingram, congratulations. I am delighted to inform you that the Committee on Admissions has admitted you to the Harvard College Class of 2024 under the Early Action Program. The committee voted to offer you admission because we believe you will make important contributions to others during your college years and beyond.
Hey, I'm Andrew Quay. I'm graduating from Southeast Guilford High School and going to be attending NC State in the fall for production systems and entrepreneurship.
Hi, my name is Kate Abbott. I will be swimming at Lees McRae College. This is my acceptance letter, and this is my national letter of intent. Go Bobcats!
Hi, my name is Reagan Cargo, and I'm graduating from Northwest Guilford High School, class of 2020. I'll be attending Limestone College in the fall. Go Saints!
Greetings, parents of the class of 2020. I am Dr. Clinton Wilson, supervisor of high school counseling, with an important message. There's still time to complete the free application for federal student aid, or FAFSA, so you can access federal and state funding to cover the cost of your students' college aspirations. We all know that the cost of college can be overwhelming. Completing the FAFSA application gives your student the opportunity to receive grants which you don't have to pay back, as well as loan options for which your family may be eligible. There are FAFSA deadlines, so don't delay. It takes approximately 30 minutes to complete. If you need assistance, please contact your student school counselor today, because it's time to run a FAFSA fast break. Put your student on the road to a bright future.
Hello, GCS families. I am Sonia Sloan, Supervisor of K-8 School Counseling for Guilford County Schools. And today, I'm here to share some exciting news with you about our new College and Career Readiness Guides. The College and Career Readiness Guides are personalized and designed to help students in grades 8 through 11 that are pursuing a diploma, preparing them for graduation and life after high school. We are the first district in the state of North Carolina to offer these guides, which will show students where they are now and what they need to do next to accomplish their goals. By using these guides, students will see their progress towards graduation, college choices, entrance requirements for college, optional career fields, along with career and technical education pathways. These guides will be sent to students through their school GCS email account. Please review these documents closely with your student. And if you have any questions, please see your student school counselor. And as always, thank you for choosing Guilford County Schools.
Hi, I'm Lyndon from Jamestown Middle School, and you're watching GCS TV.
I chose to continue my studies at Penn Griffin because I enjoy playing the arts, just being around people with that kind of drive and mindset to work at their craft and exceed expectations is the standard I like to hold myself accountable to. I started playing guitar in the sixth grade, second semester. I chose guitar because my grandfather actually played bass guitar. He was the first, he lives in Virginia. But he was the first African-American sheriff of Virginia. So I chose guitar, bass, kind of from him. I kind of picked it up due to him. He introduced me to artists such as B.B. King, Jimi Hendrix. Those were big back in his day. Unfortunately, with the passing of my father in November of last year, it kind of made me think about different things as I played. So I used to only play guitar just for audiences and just my family members, but now I'm kind of playing for him also. That's just my way of expressing myself. I was involved with the student government throughout all 4 years of high school. I went to the High Point University and High Point Police Force Youth Leadership Academy. That was a great experience. It was a week-long summer event where we kind of went to various service learning areas and just gained hours while helping our community at the same time. I also went to Anytown, which is sponsored by NCCJ. That was a great experience, absolutely phenomenal up there on that mountain. Just learning different people's stories and perspectives on life, because normally you would just go about your life, but you don't realize what other people go through also. This fall, I will be going to the University of North Carolina at Charlotte. I will be a communications major there, where I hope to hopefully go into broadcasting. So I want to do sports casting, such as ESPN or ABC News or something like that. That would be a lot of fun. Unfortunately, with the school year being cut short, that does not define our accomplishments. This 1 year will not get the best of us, and I think that we have a lot in store for us in the class of 2020. I thought we make class of 2024 even better. That's all I'm saying.
They grow up so fast, and before you know it, it's time for college. But with an NC529 account, you'll be ready. With the NC 529 plan, you can start a tax-advantaged account for your child's future for just $25. Just open an account, make periodic contributions, and with each passing year, watch it grow, just like your child. Visit nc529.org today and picture a bright future for your child.
I'm from Andrews High School, and I got accepted at the art school at UNCG. Go Spartans!
Hi, I'm Sinaya Ellison, a senior at Penn Griffin School for the Arts. I'll be attending UNC Chapel Hill this fall, majoring in computer science.
My name is Sean Lawrence, and I've been accepted to UNC Charlotte. Go Niners!
My name is Carly O'Connell, and I'm a senior at Page High School. I will be attending Appalachian State University, where I will major in exercise science, with minors in military science, psychology, and chemistry. My goal is to be a physical therapist in the Army. Go Mountaineers!
How will 2020 census data be used? Where there are more people, there are more needs for public services. That's why the census is used by the government to inform funding decisions each year. But that's not all. It's also used by nonprofits to inform services, by businesses to create jobs, and even by students for school projects. Understanding how the population changes helps us shape communities across the country for the better. Shape your future. Start here. Visit 2020census.gov.
El censo cuenta todos los que vivimos en este país, incluyendo aquellos que no pensarías que también cuentan. Una persona en el hospital, sí, cuenta. Miguelito que acaba de nacer, sí, Miguelito ya cuenta. Los García y los Álvarez que comparten la misma casa, sí, todos cuentan. El primo Luis que acaba de llegar al país y está viviendo en el garaje de Pedro, también cuenta. El censo cuenta a todos para que a todos nos vaya mejor.
Everybody, I have a new game for us. It's called Crunch Tossers, and we are going to work on our abdominal muscles, our foot-eye coordination, and a whole bunch of other things. Here's what you need for this activity: a laundry basket or a big bucket, 5 soft items that you can grab with your feet. Now, I chose sock bowls because, well, they're a good size. You might have some stuffed animals, some smaller pillows, nothing too large because it's got to fit into the basket. Here's how the setup goes. Take all 5 items and put them just outside. Okay, and at the other end, you're going to put your laundry basket. Now, you're going to sit with your back to the laundry basket, okay? And the balls are down here by your feet. You can only use your feet for this activity, and you have to do this 20 times. All right, let me show you how it goes. You're gonna take one item, and you're gonna grab it between your feet. Notice no hands. I'm gonna lay down, rock over my head, and deposit the ball. Grab another one, no hands, over, good. I'm doing crunches. I'm working on my abs and my core right here. Grab another one and let go. I'm also working on some foot-eye coordination because my feet are doing the work and my brain's telling them what to do. Grab another one, that's four. You want to make it really hard? Put your hands in the air. Five. That's five. I have 15 more to do. Let me get these and start again. All right, here we go. Oh, I'm getting a little tired now. I'm still going to keep my hands up way backwards. Six. Oh, here comes it. Oh, this is a tough one. Seven. Did it get it? It made it in. Thank goodness. All right. Eight. Ooh. Uh-oh. These are really close to my body. Oh, I missed that one. I'll have to use my hand to get back in the spot. Oh, these things are slippery. Eight. No, that was nine. And 10. Well, that was 10. You're gonna have to do 10 more. So for a total of 20 crunch tossing exercises, you should have some really good strong abs. Have fun with this game, boys and girls. See you.
I'd like to congratulate the entire class of 2020.
About 10 years ago at Haynes Inman that we had the opportunity to dream big while we opened a new school building and a new community. We now have about 140 students from ages 3 to 22, all of whom have special needs. Many are considered medically fragile with significant disabilities. When this coronavirus came and we had to continue our teaching and learning for all of our students, we had the relationships in place to be able to continue that. It just felt we're just doing it in a different way. Our staff knows the things that are important for our kids. They know those traditions that are important. We had a Zoom prom last Friday. We've had a drive-through cookout for staff. We've done Zoom meetings, and we've tried to continue a lot of the routines and traditions that are important to our family. We've got split screens now where we're doing shared reading, and somebody's demonstrating on a core board, somebody's reading a story, somebody is using sign language in hopes that all of our kids can benefit from those lessons.
Paying careful attention to that school culture and climate has really equipped us to face this crisis, because we've already invested the time and effort in developing that trust and collaboration among our staff and our students and families. And we're continuing to focus and work on those relationships while supporting each other and meeting each other where we're at now.
You know, especially in working with kids with disabilities, you quickly learn that one size does not fit all. And so the district has certainly provided a wonderful platform for us to provide lessons to our kids virtually. But for some of our kids, you know, access to that is difficult. So what we have done is we've tried to distribute our lessons in as many different ways as we possibly can. You know, knowing who's going to be able to access this platform, or who might need to see it on, you know, by an email, or by Facebook, or by through a Zoom lesson, or who might need somebody to just drop by and drop things off, you know, so that they can get that material.
I think it's been amazing to see how our families have taken on this at-home learning. They've been sending us photos and videos of them doing lessons at home, and it's so encouraging to see everybody is in this together.
We knew kind of what we wanted to be when we opened up. You know, we talked about, you know, respect and dignity. And then the 11 principles, I think they just reinforced that idea for us, you know, how important relationships were and how big the community actually is.
Focusing on those principles of character has helped us to look for the good in our school community. And I think that when you're looking for the good and acknowledging and celebrating good character, it has a snowball effect into even more positive outcomes.
I mean, it's the best place around, and I get to make a difference every day. And you know what? The students do the same for us. They look for stuff every single day. And that's what school should be. And, you know, they can all be joyful places. You just have to see the good in one another and know that it comes in all kinds of different packages. And as long as we're supporting each other, we're going to have a good place.
I think that we've learned that our students teach us just as much or more than we teach them.
That we come to school just the way we're supposed to. And that all of our students, in fact, all of our students, staff, and families, you know, we're deserving of love. And we're deserving of a sense of belonging. And all of our students are capable of learning. And they deserve our very best.
Hi, I'm Candace Jenkins from Andrews High School, and you're watching GCS TV.
All right, Southwest, hi. It was challenging the first year just because it's a new introduction to a new chapter of your life. But as things went on, it got a lot easier, a lot more enjoyable, and overall it was pretty fun. I would say one of my favorite classes in high school had to have been physics with Mr. Bronstein, just because it wasn't like any other class. There was always something to do with your hands and physical representation of what you're learning. So it wasn't just piece of paper and you have to understand that. There was imagery behind it, so you could actually see what was happening and get a full understanding of it. My brother did the GAP program a couple years back, and So that's how I knew about it. The GAP program was right in front of me, and it's such a great opportunity, I thought I might as well just take it while I still have the chance. I was able to sign with Grady Services. It's an HVAC-based company, but we also do pipe fitting, electrical, IT, and a couple other things. I was extremely thrilled whenever I got the news that I officially was signed on. Whenever I was told that I got the High School Apprentice of the Year award, I didn't even know I signed up for it. Met in one of our HR people. She called me and said, "Hey, Levi, could you stop by my office? I have some great news for you." And so, of course, I went, and she goes, "You just won High School Apprentice of the Year." And I go, "Okay," just because it hasn't registered in my brain yet. And it took about a full week before I realized the how big of an achievement it truly was. Congratulations to all of my fellow classmates who have made it this far. I wish you the best of luck in your adventures with the rest of your life, and I hope that you achieve everything that you want to.
My name is Sydney Parker, and I attend the STEM Early College at North Carolina A&T, and I've been accepted to North Carolina A&T State University.
Hey, I'm Joshua McDonald. I graduated the Early Middle College at GCCC Jamestown, and I'm headed to Appalachian State University.
Hey, my name is Sophia Lorenzo, and I'm a senior at the Middle College of Bennett, and in the fall, I'll be attending UNCG.
Hey, my name is Jamari Rogers. I am a senior at Page High School. I played football there, and I was also a part of a club called Team Voyage. After high school, I have decided to stay local and attend GTCC for 2 years to start on my business management career. And then I plan on transferring to North Carolina A&T.
My name is Margaret Lucas. I'm a senior at Northwest Guilford High School, and I've decided to attend NC State.
My name is Sierra Main, and I'm a senior at Southwest Guilford High School. This fall, I'll be attending Western Carolina University, where I'll be majoring in history with a concentration on late 19th century to mid 20th century Western history. I can't wait to be a part of the Catamount community.
I'm just down here hanging out on the floor. Actually, we're getting ready for our new warm-up that I'm going to teach you today. It's pretty simple. You need, well, three things. You're going to need a paper plate, a grocery bag, and some sort of finish line. Right here, I have just some tape down on the floor. So, let me get set up and I'll show you how to play. So here we are at the starting line, paper plate, plastic bag, and one hand. Now when you do this, you have to use the paper plate to fan the bag. You can't touch the bag with your hand, and you cannot touch the bag with the plate. You ready? I got to get all the way across that finish line. Let's see how this goes. Oh boy, come on. No, not that way, not that way. Get out of there. Oh dear. Woo! To make this a true challenge, we have levels. Begin at the star, 10 steps between your start line and your finish line. Move to level 1 and onward. How many levels can you make it through? Thank you.
Greetings to all of our GCS families. My name is Jamari Hooks, and I attend the engineering program at Smith High School. We are asking you to help the schools in our district by completing the 2020 census. Taking the 2020 census can help increase our fundings for after-school programs, technology in the classrooms, school breakfast, and lunch. The census can also help by funding our Title I schools. As a student in a career and technical education program, not taking a census can affect the funding that my school may receive. Please help students like me by taking the 2020 census so we can receive the best education from our teachers. At GCS, we are all in it for the students. Log on to 2020census.gov to take the census today so together we can be all in it for GCS. Again, that is 2020census.gov.
Look into my eyes, you will see what you mean to me. Don't tell me it's not worth trying for. You know it's true. Everything I do it for you.
Welcome to all of our families and scholars. Thank you for tuning in to our virtual National Junior Honor Society induction ceremony. You know, each spring here at Allen J. Prep, we identify scholars who are eligible for participation in this Honor Society based on their academic and social performance. And then those scholars must complete an application and also participate in an interview with a staff member who sits on this committee. This is a very highly esteemed honor, and we recognize these scholars by providing them with a National Junior Honor Society pin. They meet regularly to plan activities that help to support and to serve both the community and scholars here at Allen J. Prep. Today, I'm really excited. We have two of our eighth grade scholars who are going to provide the names for our induction ceremony. Please welcome Sophie and Eliza.
Greetings from Allen J. Prep Academy. I'm excited to welcome you to our virtual induction ceremony for the National Junior Honor Society. My name is Sophie Wheat, and this year I have served as the president of Allen J. Prep's chapter of the National Junior Honor Society. One of the main elements of the Honor Society is to provide service to others. This year, our chapter organized a fundraising event for the United Way by challenging each classroom to fill a water bottle full of dimes. The Dasani Dimes Project resulted in our school helping to support members of our community in a fun way and a creative way. We also organized the Teacher Appreciation Staff Drive-Thru event where teachers were celebrated for all the great things they do for Allen J. Prep.
My name is Eliza Graham, and I'm the Vice President of the National Junior Honor Society at Allen J. Prep. Another campaign that our chapter sponsored this year was Penny for Pasta campaign to support Leukemia and Lymphoma Society to battle childhood cancer. We challenged scholars to donate to this campaign in an effort to help others across the country who are battling cancer.
Recently, a list of scholars were notified that they qualify for the National Junior Honor Society based on their academic and social performance. Each of them completed an application and took part in an interview that challenged them to share their leadership experiences and ideas to helping our school. Eliza and I are happy to announce these scholars as the newest members of the National Junior Honor Society at Allen J. Prep. Bianca Acosta.
Sheila Goins.
Janiah Hamilton.
Javion Jones.
Carson Laney.
Anderson Lynch.
Jonathan McNair.
Max Nissen.
Aislinn Pierce.
Marissa Pringle.
Addison Ward.
Hutch Wheat.
Carmen Williams.
Jayla Barbie.
Kalani Daniel.
Tess Lingle.
Tamaya Perry.
James Spencer.
Araya Ashley.
Sasanya Bent.
Dottie Braswell.
Abigail Brockington.
Justin Bryant.
Nydia Clark.
Holly Gaston.
Hannah Hadima.
Zaniah Hicks.
Olivia Johnson.
Madison Kelly.
Zaryab Khan.
Aaron Meadows.
And Abigail Williams. In closing, we would like to challenge all members of the National Junior Honor Society to continue looking for ways to serve others, especially during this challenging time. Simple things like words of encouragement and helping your family members are little ways that you can demonstrate leadership. and represent the National Junior Honor Society. We are proud of our newest members and hope each of you continue the great legacy that has been established at Allen J. Prep. We encourage you to always choose integrity first, service above self, and excellence in all you do.
Hey, greetings to all of our Allen J. Prep scholars and families. We are gathering today in order to recognize the significant achievements of so many of our scholars throughout the 2019 and 2020 school year. Obviously, this event is a little bit different than normal. It is a virtual event, but our staff has come in shifts and rotations in order to record their presentations. We still want to call scholars' names, and we still want to celebrate the great things that you have achieved during this school year. Hey, I want to begin by recognizing some scholars who have had perfect attendance all the way from the first day of school back in early August up until the time of school closure. That's a pretty significant achievement when you think about all the many school days and opportunities that you may have had to miss a day, take a vacation, or even be sick. So this is a great, significant achievement for these scholars, and I would like to call each of their names. Let's recognize these fifth grade scholars for perfect attendance, 145 days straight of being in school. Ms. Micaiah Barnes, Ryan Brown, Christian Campbell, Elijah Farrow, Andrew Hardy, Storm Jones, Mary Claire King, Jaslyn Malavat, Jordan McNeil, Alexandria Sauls, Maggie Stevens-Gales, and Mallory Wood. Those fifth grade scholars were present every single day this school year. Congratulations. Let's talk about sixth grade scholars that also have perfect attendance. Congratulations to Jackie Kazaran-Peloza, Deja Gill, Aiden Griffith, Makai Hand, Hosiah Hadima, Sanaje Jones, Zariah Jones, Maham Khan, Sophia McKnight, Jonathan McNair, Zakia McNeil, Marissa Pringle, Deja Smith, Herzl Smith, Anston Thompson, and Addison Ward. Congratulations to those scholars. In seventh grade, I'd also like to recognize scholars for perfect attendance. This is not an easy task to accomplish, so we celebrate you. Fidelia Ashy, Nigel Baker, Mercedes Brown, Kalani Daniel, Yareli Delgado Martinez, Courtney Griffith, Alston James, Mubin Khan, Muhammad Khan, Antonio McCoy, Tamaya Perry, Jeremiah Pettyjohn, Jameson Poteet, Aaron Sauls, Catherine Villatoro Balcazar, and Victoria Williams. Congratulations. We celebrate those scholars, appreciate your diligence and consistent focus at Allen J. Prep. Congratulations on perfect attendance for this school year. Hey, it's my pleasure to also recognize scholars who have achieved A honor roll for the entire school year. What does that mean? It means that in each of the first three quarters of this school year, they had an A in every single class. And that is truly remarkable. Later, when we celebrate our eighth graders, we will be acknowledging two scholars who have actually maintained the A honor roll for four consecutive years. So congratulations to these scholars because you're on the A honor roll for the entire 2019 and 2020 school year. I'm gonna begin in fifth grade. It's Ms. Madeline Brady, Mr. Jeremiah Davis Hall, Layla Drew, Cadence Goodman, Grace Jaggernoth, Nan Laney, Quincy Long, Maris Morgan, Maya Nichols, and Adam Teal. Congratulations to those fifth grade scholars. Let's look at our sixth graders that have also achieved this accomplishment. We're gonna begin with Ms. Bianca Acosta, Sela Goins, Janiyah Hamilton, Carson Laney, Marissa Pringle, and Addison Ward. Congratulations to those scholars. Also in seventh grade, these young men and women have maintained A honor roll throughout the entire school year. Camden Austin, Deja Brooks, Aubrey Brown, Emily Harris, Destiny Hewitt, Ella Lindsay, Addison Perry, Jenna Pravat, James Umplett, Catherine Villatoro Balcazar. Each of them will receive an A honor roll pin as a way to acknowledge their honor roll for the entire school year. Congratulations. At this time, we'd like to transition. I'm going to have some core and encore teachers come to present some awards as well.
Each year, we honor one deserving female scholar who exemplifies integrity, social and academic excellence, and consistently demonstrates all-star expectations. The Phillips Foundation has been instrumental in the creation of Allen J. Prep through generous contributions and support. This year's Phillips honoree is a very special young lady who represents the spirit of this award to a T. One of my favorite football coaches of all time, Lou Holtz, once said, "Ability is what you're capable of doing. Motivation determines what you do, and attitude determines how well you do it." I think this scholar embraces these characteristics because she is intrinsically motivated. She tries her absolute best and exhibits a positive attitude on a daily basis. This year's Phillips Award winner is the very deserving Grace Jagernoth.
The Ellison Award, similar to the Phillips Award, is given in honor of John Ellison, a local businessman who believed in the vision of HAP and donated a significant amount of money towards the establishment and development of Allen J. The young man we have chosen to receive the Ellison Award is probably the most courteous and genuinely interesting young man I've ever met. He oftentimes would ask questions that would take a lesson to the next level, or oftentimes take the lesson somewhere entirely different. He had real conversations with you. He never seemed to get rattled when we gave him additional challenges. He was always quick to smile, seemed to always understand my dry sense of humor, and truly cared about the people around him. It is in our opinion he represents the pillars exceptionally well, serving others, having a strong sense of integrity and excellence in everything he does, plus a little bit more. Every day, we could not do our job without you. We honor and respect Adam Teal.
Our first fifth grade Scholar Excellence Award goes to a scholar who was always willing to offer a helping hand, consistently showed up to class with a positive attitude, worked diligently on classroom assignments, and made creative contributions to classroom discussions. She embodies integrity, service, and excellence. We have enjoyed watching her grow into a young leader, and we are so proud of her. Congratulations to Maya Nichols.
The next Scholar Excellence Award that we've chosen, I have the honor of giving out, goes to a young man who many, I think, would agree is one of the quietest scholars in fifth grade. Obviously, this is not a bad thing, as he's receiving this award. Despite his quiet demeanor, his presence in the classroom is loved by all and respected as he works hard every day to do what is asked of him, leading the rest by example. He is always ready to lend a helping hand, recognizes there's joy in serving others, and was, believe it or not, becoming a more vocal leader in the classroom. Congratulations, Chance. I'm so proud of you for the growth over this year.
Our next Scholar of Excellence Award goes to a young man who's very hardworking. He's always willing to help out in the classroom, and he keeps me on my toes with all my reminders that I ask him to remember for me. He exhibits all-star expectations each and every day, and he also helps to keep the class hype. Please join in as I celebrate Jerry McCain.
Our final Scholar Excellence Award goes to another young lady that I have really enjoyed teaching this year. Seldom do you come across a scholar that leaves such a lasting impression on you, and this scholar's wonderful and infectious attitude towards learning was evident daily. She cares so much about her success and works diligently to improve herself. I teach science, but I've had the privilege this year of reading some of this scholar's stories, and she is just a wonderful writer and is talented beyond her years. I am very lucky and honored to present this Scholar Excellence Award to Nan Laney.
The award for excellence in mathematics this year goes to a scholar who brought enthusiasm and positive energy to math class. This scholar was a valued participant in class and was at her best when she was helping her peers. I appreciate her hard work and consistent drive to improve. Congratulations to expert mathematician Maris Morgan.
The person I have chosen for my Excellence in Social Studies Award is probably one of the most conscientious, hardworking, and honest people I've ever met when it comes to classwork. This person always has questions, makes sure there are no gray areas with any assignment, and is always willing to help out the people around her. For those reasons, I have chosen Anna Fields for my Social Studies Award.
My Excellence in Reading Award goes to a scholar who always has a book in her hand. So no matter where you see her, no matter what you're doing, she's gonna definitely have that book reading at all times, sometimes during the wrong times of the class period. She contributes to class discussions, and she provides a very unique perspective on certain topics that are discussed during class time. We always appreciate her perspective, and she works hard each and every day during our reading class. I want to celebrate Madeline Brady.
My Science Excellence Award goes to a young man with a brilliant scientific mind. He has proven time and time again that science is an area of interest, and he works really hard in this area each and every day. He's kept me on my toes, he's got a great laugh, he's also not a bad rapper. My Science Excellence Award goes to Jaden Mitchell.
I'm excited to present the Phillips and Ellison Award winners for this year for sixth grade. The Phillips and Ellison Award go to our outstanding and our top scholars in sixth grade. So I have the honor of presenting these awards to two outstanding scholars. The Ellison Award goes to an outstanding scholar, a male scholar, who has really exceeded our expectations. And he's an outstanding scholar inside and outside of the classroom. So the Ellison Award winner for this year is Javion Jones. And next, our Phillips Award is gonna go to an outstanding female scholar who is an outstanding scholar inside and outside the classroom. She's a leader amongst her peers. And the Phillips Award winner for this year is Ms. Sela Goins.
All right, hey, good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. I'm glad you're watching. I'm Mr. Van Newkirk, sixth grade science teacher here at Allen J. Prep, and I just want to thank you for the privilege of teaching here. It has been an excellent year. You've made my first year here a memorable one, and I'll never forget it. So I want to thank you. But without further ado, I do want to go ahead and recognize the most improved scholars in sixth grade this year. First off, we have a young lady who started off. She started off quiet, but as she gained in confidence, her grades began to rise, she began to speak, and she just became a shining star here at Allen J. Prep. So Amaya Hilton is our female most improved student for the sixth grade. All right, and our male most improved scholar for this sixth grade is another young scholar who started off kind of weak, but then as he began to become more and more confident, he started to participate more, he started to turn his work in on time, his quality of work began to improve dramatically. And so we want to thank him very, very much for doing his best, and he's continuing to kill it online. So this student is none other than Braden Hatfield.
Hey, sixth grade and everybody else. Miss you guys and hope you all are doing well. So I'm here to present sixth grade scholar excellence. So when the sixth grade team got together and thought about scholar excellence, we thought about what it meant to be an all-star all around, not just academically in the classroom. When we considered these scholars, we thought about their engagement in the classroom, their character, their leadership, and their willingness to serve others. Engaged not only in the classroom, but also socially and emotionally aware, these scholars exemplify what it means to be an all-star. Congratulations to Carson Laney and Christian Griffin. My next award is for language arts, my special all-star. So this scholar is such an affable and helpful scholar. She's always helping me out in the classroom, and I can always count on her to get me smiling with a good joke. Congratulations to Maham Khan.
What's going on, everybody? This is Mr. Smith, sixth grade math teacher. Just wanted to say good job for this year. We want to give you guys a big congratulations. We know that it's been a tough time, but you guys have made it. And I wanted to highlight two scholars for excellence in math. Being a new teacher, it's not very easy coming in the way I did, but these two scholars definitely helped me out, made it easy for me to come in and teach. They were fun, they were engaging. Like I said, just made it easy for me. So I want to give a big shout out and a congratulations to Caleb Milton and Max Nissen. Those two, congratulations. You have been engaging. You were always smiling. You always made it easy. You were cool with your classmates, and you made teaching math for me very easy, especially at the end of the day. So congratulations to you too, and thank you.
Hey, at Allen J. Prep, we know that we are the all-stars, and all of our sixth graders here at Allen J. are all-stars, but I have one shining all-star that has just shined above and beyond. They radiate just excellence in everything they do. And I just want to go ahead and thank these two scholars because they kind of come together. They came into this earth together, and they are just amazing to have in the classroom. And that is Gabby and Addison Ward. They are my shining all-stars here for sixth grade science.
This year's Social Studies Award goes to an amazing scholar. Especially throughout this online learning experience, he has still given 100%, just as he would have inside of the classroom. I miss his drumming inside of the classroom. I miss his energy, but I still can feel it through the online learning. So this year's Social Studies Award goes to Mr. Javen Bays.
It is my honor to announce the Phillips Academic Achievement Award. This goes to the top female scholar who shows excellence above in every content in all areas and just really shines each and every day. And that's a perfect description of our honoree, Deja Brooks. Congratulations.
The Ellison Award is given out annually to one male scholar who demonstrates excellence, not just in academics, but also in the social and leadership components of life that we strive to build within our young leaders today. We as a seventh grade team are proud and honored to give this award to Mr. Aaron Sauce.
So guys, after teaching everyone for 2 years, it is my pleasure to send you to eighth grade. And honestly, thinking back over the last 2 years, it's been my pleasure to teach you. We've had such great times together. I feel like I've grown to know many of you on a personal level, and I just wanted to say that I love you guys, that I am proud of you, and I expect great things from you in the future. Please know that you always can reach out to me, and I will help you in any way I can, if it's academically, socially, emotionally. However, know that I am for you and that I will do anything I can to help you. So with that said, I want to give out my science award This scholar is dear to my heart. She has a great personality. She is very different from a lot of people in the way she dresses and the way she, you know, has her hair and everything like that. And that's one thing that I love about her, is that she is her own person. And she is a Disney lover, and she loves going, and she has a great family, and just a really cool person, and has artistic ability out the wazoo. But also, she has a great scientific brain. She loves to learn. She asks questions that are challenging. And so I want to give my science award for seventh grade to Miss Tess Lingle.
This scholar goes above and beyond on every social studies assignment. He is always quick to ask questions if he needs help or assistance, and always follows through on his commitments. The Excellence in Social Studies Award goes to Nigel Baker. This year, I've had so many scholars just rise and shine as they work and struggle through math, and many scholars have stood out. But there's one scholar who not only just pushed herself each and every day, but also assisted her peers as well. And so it is my honor to give the Excellence in Math this year's award goes to Kalani Daniels.
The scholar I recognize today for excellence in ELA is a quiet force in the classroom. She contributes when needed, and every time she does is full of quality. I appreciate her level of thought and the detail of her work. Proud to recognize Ms. Destiny Hewitt.
These scholars are individuals who embody the principles of AJP. They are helpful, respectful, and hard workers in every arena of life. They strive to grow and excel. Congrats to our Scholar Excellence Awards, Tamaya Perry and Vera Fossa.
We want to give a Most Improved Award in seventh grade, and I feel the most confident in giving this award out to this particular scholar. She has improved not only academically, but also socially, and just making wiser choices. And I'm so proud of the accomplishments she has done in seventh grade, and I hope and pray that she continues to push forward and continues to work hard and make good decisions as she moves into eighth grade. So I want to give a Most Improved Scholar Award to Ms. Whitney Brazier.
Academic excellence is an expectation we hold of all scholars here at AJP. However, some scholars stand out for the strength and the effort they put into their pursuit of their title. As a seventh grade team, we're proud and honored to recognize Ella Lindsay and James Umford as our Academic Excellence Scholars this year.
Lastly, we want to give out one Perseverance Award as a seventh grade team. And I want to especially say that this scholar has become very dear to my heart. Also, her mom has become very dear to my heart. She has put up a huge fight this year, and she has shared some of her story, not only with myself and the team, but also she was brave and she shared it with her classmates. And so we want to give a Perseverance Award for the 2019-2020 school year to Ms. Channing Callens.
Hello, scholars. Coach Barker here to give out excellence in 5th, 6th, 7th grade. First, for my 5th grade, I'd like to congratulate Evan Davis on an outstanding year as my excellence in physical education. Good job, Evan. Next, for 6th grade, it's had a great year for me, a lot of improvement. I'd like to recognize Javion Jones for excellence in physical education, 6th grade. Good job, Javion. And last but not least for me, she brings a smile every day. She's a pleasure to have around. Misa Brumby for excellence in 7th grade physical education. Good job, Misa. Thank y'all. See y'all next year. Love you, scholars.
All right. I would like to recognize three students, 1, 5th, 6th, and 7th, for their consistency, hard work, and effort throughout the 2019-2020 school year. And although they may not be the most outspoken in the classroom, they lead with their scholarly behaviors and their desire to always be the best they can be. So for fifth grade, I would like to recognize Haley Ull for excellence in Spanish for the 2019-2020 school year. In sixth grade, I would like to recognize Caleb Milton. And in seventh grade, I would like to recognize Deja Brooks. Thank you. I'd like to recognize three scholars from fifth, sixth, and seventh grade for their excellence during the 2019-2020 school year. Our first fifth grade scholar has demonstrated consistent effort and persistence, both in the classroom and in distance learning, so I would like to recognize Cadence Goodman for that. Our second scholar in sixth grade has been hardworking, focused, and consistent all year long, and I'd like to recognize Hosiah Hadima for that. And in seventh grade, this student has a positive attitude, is a leader, and supports her classmates, and goes above and beyond, and I'd like to recognize Deja Brooks.
Hey everybody, just have three awards today for Ben. Been working very hard, whether it's at school or at home. I'm very proud of these individuals. So for fifth grade, my award for excellence is Miss Grace Jaggernoff. For sixth grade, this scholar is outstanding, always trying to do the best. Award goes to Mr. Caleb Milton. And for seventh grade, been rocking it in distance learning, Miss Destiny Hewitt. So give them a hand.
Hi everyone. I want to give out some awards for excellence in chorus for all county chorus this year. These scholars were excellent all year long in the classroom and also exhibited the same thing when we went to our all county chorus events. For fifth grade, I have Miss Grace Jaggernoff, Mr. Jerry McCain, Miss Maya Nichols, and Miss Julia King. For sixth grade, we have Sela Goins, Marissa Pringle, Trinity Ratliff, and Dacia Smith. For seventh grade, all county chorus and excellence in chorus, we have Miss Sarah Queen. And for eighth grade, we have Abby Williams, Erilyn Stewart, Anya Kirby, Rebecca Guevara, Sydney Mitchell, Jamie Patton, and Zach Cohen. Thank you guys.
Hi, good afternoon, Alan Jay. I am here to present the Excellence in Physical Education and Health Awards. You know, this is a really hard decision because all of my scholars do well every year, every semester, and I really appreciate you guys putting in the effort, especially during your online learning. So I would like to recognize Excellence in Physical Education to Grace Jaggernoff. For my male, in fifth grade, I would like to recognize excellence in physical education to Kyrie Winchester. Congratulations, scholars. Next, for sixth grade, I would like to recognize excellence in physical education and in health. This individual is an awesome individual, never complains, always do what they need to do, and they are consistently turning in their online assignments. I would like to recognize Brandon Richards. And for my female, I would like to recognize Ms. Shamaya Housie. For seventh grade, excellence in physical education and health, I would like to recognize for our male, Cameron McNeil. And also, for my female, I would like to recognize excellence in physical education and health, Ms. Tess Ling.
Good morning, my name is Mr. McDuffie, and today I'll be presenting excellence in computer science discoveries and computer science. These three scholars exemplified excellence throughout the year. So for my first award, fifth grade, Adam Teal. For sixth grade, Miss Sophia McKnight. And for seventh grade, Miss Tess Lingle.